These mini portable projectors are getting super popular nowadays. It's like a smart TV that you can take just about anywhere. It's the size of, well, slightly larger than a soda can and smaller than this pickles jar. And the design is just super convenient. It's a projector, speaker, and battery all built in, so it's totally cordless. Plus it has that autofocus and auto keystoning, and it has the smart TV apps built in. There's a ton here. My brother-in-law just bought one for himself and his kids. My buddy Dalton has one. They both say that they use them all the time. I'm Ben Schmicke from AuthenTech, and in this video, we're gonna be comparing two portable projectors from Anker Nebula. Big thanks to those guys for sponsoring this video. These two models, the Capsule 3 and the Capsule 3 Laser, they have a lot of similarities, but some unique differences and features that you should know. So by the end of this video, you should have a better idea of which one might be the better fit for you. Starting with the dimensions and size and weight, the Capsule 3 is just slightly smaller, 78mm by 160mm and 1.8 pounds. The Capsule 3 Laser is just slightly larger at 83mm by 170mm and slightly heavier at 2.1 pounds. Both of them though, still very small, compact, and lightweight and portable. And another thing to note, not only is the small and lightweight size great for just portability, you could slide this in your pocket or backpack or wherever, but also makes it easy to place it in any space close or far from your walls or ceilings, and it just automatically works. I love that there's no manual calibration needed. It makes it much more enjoyable and fun to use. So let me first cover a lot of the key similarities between the two. Both of them are 1080p, both of them have the battery and speaker built in. And for that 1080p, I'd say it actually looks really good. I was impressed. I think possibly because there's no exact pixels that we're used to seeing like in a TV, the image has this nice blending effect, and in return, the picture quality looks sharp. Now, of course, darkening the room will drastically help, and I tried it in various brightness scenarios to test it out. And even though with the lights on and window shades open and you can still see the picture, I think it looks a little bit better quality when you can dim down those lights. Pitch black would be awesome. The speakers are really loud. They have 8-watt Dolby audio. I was very impressed here as well. It's super nice setting up a movie night with the kids, and there's no lugging speakers and wires and junk around. You just hit play, and the built-in sound quality was impressively loud. Here's a little speaker test. Those speakers crank loud, and I was only at 67%. It's also fun to experiment with moving the projector closer to your ears or maybe even behind you, and then with a wall there to bounce the sound back, it helps with that fake surround sound effect. Battery life seems really good too. Both of them say that they're rated up to 2.5 hours in eco mode, so that's basically watching a full length movie. Both of them charge via USB Type-C, and I really like this versatility. It's easy to recharge anywhere, or you can plug them in and use it around the house for much longer lengths of time, or you could even use a battery bank if it supports that power delivery fast charging, and then you could extend that usage off-grid like camping or up on a mountain or wherever. Both of them have the autofocus and auto keystone feature, which is just really awesome. You just basically point the thing at any wall, ceiling, angle, whatever, and with some sensors built in, it's gonna automatically trigger that autofocus and auto keystoning, which will make that image nice and sharp, and then it'll snap in those edges so it looks nice and parallel and level. And then with the remote control, you can manually hit this, or you could dial in the corners if you wanna refine the edges. Now, one difference and bonus feature here goes to the new Capsule 3. It also sports Intelligent Environment Adaption 3.0, which includes the obstacle avoidance and auto screen fit. It's very cool. Both of them have a projection size from 40 inches up to 120 inches. Now here's what 120 inches looks like approximately, and it is massive. That is a really big screen, and it's super cool that something in this tiny package can display an image that large. You really truly can take these anywhere around your house or in your backyard or camping adventures, and then have a cinematic movie experience anywhere. It's super cool. For mounting and placement, they're about the same. You can just place them on a flat surface and good to go. Or if you want to angle them, well, they both have a nice standard quarter 20 tripod mount on the bottom. So you could use any tripod, big or small, to angle it upwards. Anker themselves even offers a few different options and sizes. I experimented with a couple little camera tripods I had laying around. I like using one that has the ball head built in, so you can slightly pivot it. And this is great if you want to tilt it all the way back,
project on the ceiling, or even project down depending on placement. I also kind of liked using this gorilla tripod. You got that ball head so you can angle it. These legs can easily wrap around a tree branch or basically anything, and as long as you got that flat surface, then you got a projection. There's multiple ports on the back to connect to external devices. There's that Type-C for charging. There's USB-A. There's HDMI in, so you could plug in some gaming devices or your Blu-ray player or whatever. There's an aux out if you want to connect to additional speakers or maybe your headphones. Both of these projectors can be put into Bluetooth speaker mode with the extended battery life up to about 8 to 10 hours of music playback. I think it's a cool little bonus feature so that if you didn't need to watch anything, you just wanted to jam to your tunes and you're camping or wherever you're at, it's got that built in. Now onto some of the key differences that you should know. For brightness, it's going to be 200 ANSI lumens versus 300 ANSI lumens. Now part of that is the light source. It's LED on the Capsule 3 and it's laser on the Capsule 3 laser. Here's a side-by-side comparison, and you should be able to see and notice the brightness difference. Now of course I prefer the brighter image coming out of the Capsule 3 laser. It's really nice to have the extra boost in brightness, but the 200 is more than usable, and it also depends on maybe your use case, where you'll be using it, ambient lights, those sort of factors. Another major difference is the operating system. Now this one, the new Capsule 3, has Google TV with official Netflix certification and support. The Capsule 3 laser has Android TV built in. I don't want to get too far into the weeds, but basically how it works, I believe, is that Netflix requires a certificate requirement for their app to work on specific smart TV platforms. And this is for DRM reasons and stuff like that. Now, in my two cents, I prefer and really enjoy the newer Google TV and Netflix experience with it all built in. Both of them have controllers and both of them have most of your apps built right in, but I just sort of like that UI of the Google TV. It's a little bit more newer, refreshed. The Android TV isn't bad by any means. I've used it for years, and you can still cast from your phone, or you can also sideload that Netflix APK if you wanted to watch Netflix directly on there. So there you have it, two very sweet portable projector options that are actually pretty affordable. It's great to take that cinematic experience anywhere you go. Both of these are awesome options, and I'll give you the links down below. Also with those links, there's some discount codes and coupons that's on their website, so make sure that if you're gonna buy, use those coupons to get those extra savings. Hit me up with any questions you have down in the comments. I'll try my best to respond, and I'll see you subscribers in my next video.